Welcome viewers. In the lecture series of information technology and its application in business, we today start with exclusive gates. In earlier lecture, we have studied that there are three basic categories of gate: the basic gates, the universal gates, and the exclusive gates, where we have defined that AND, OR, and NOT are basic gates. NAND and NOR are universal gates that are derived from AND, OR, and NOT. Now, let us understand the exclusive gates. We say that the exclusive gates has very specific property that these gates are based on principle of mutual exclusion and principle of equality. That means, there are two exclusive gates. One gate is based on principle of mutual exclusion and second gate is based on the principle of equality. Or in other words, we say that if we say we are having inputs as mutually exclusive inputs, then the output is 1. It is called as XOR gate. And if we say that the inputs are same and the output is 1, then it is called as XNOR gate. One very important thing we have to note about exclusive gates that these gates has only 2 inputs and 1 output. That means, you will not be having a XOR gate or XNOR gate with 3 inputs or 4 inputs. Although logically you can create, but practically you will not find a gate with more than 2 inputs. So, now we say the XOR gate is exclusive OR gate, the XNOR gate is exclusive NOR gate. Now, let us first define exclusive OR gate, also called as XOR gate. Now, we say the OR gate is provided with a curve at the input. This is called as symbol of exclusion. The symbol of exclusion says that if A is true, B is false. If B is true, A is false. So, we say formally X equal to A XOR B. In equation form, it is defined as A bar B. That means, if A is negative, B is positive, or if A is positive, then B is negative. That means, A and B are mutually exclusive. This is AB mutually exclusive. This is also AB mutually exclusive. It says that if either of them is true, then the output is true. The logical symbol is nothing but a plus, that is the OR sign enclosed in a circle, which is nothing but the exclusion symbol. So, now we say the XOR gate has only 2 inputs and only 1 output, where from the truth table we say if both the inputs are same, that is 0, 0, the output is 0. If both the inputs are same, that is 1, 1, then also the output is 0. If the input is 0 and 1, the output is 1, or if the input is 1 and 0, then the output is 1. That means, if the inputs are mutually exclusive, then and then the output is 1. Now, the formal definition of XOR gate says, the output Z is true if A and B are mutually exclusive. Another definition says that the output Z is false if A and B are similar. That means, if the inputs are similar, the output is 0. If the inputs are different, the output is 1. Let us talk of the next gate, that is exclusive NOR gate. In the exclusive NOR gate, the symbol remains the same as of XOR, but the output is provided by a bubble that is also called as negation. Or we say that XNOR gate is nothing but a negation of XOR gate. So, we say it is defined as Z equal to A XNOR B, or we say it is defined in terms of equation as A bar B bar plus A B. That means, the inputs both are similar here, that is A bar and B bar, or the inputs are similar as A B. That means, either both the inputs are in complemented form, then the output is true, or either both the inputs are in normal form, then the output is true. So, we say that there are two symbols of XNOR gate. The first is a dot represented in a circle and the second is called as sign of equivalence represented by 3 horizontal lines. So, we say that this is nothing but the representation of XNOR gate acting as equivalence gate, let us understand it by truth table. From the truth table, we find that if A and B both are same, both are 0, 0, then the output is 1, or if the inputs are 1 and 1, that is they are same, then again the output is 1. The output of this gate is 0 if and only if both the inputs are mutually exclusive. We find from the definition, we say the output Z is true if A and B are similar, that is equal, also called as equivalence. And the second definition says that the output is false if A and B are mutually exclusive. So now we say XOR and XNOR are opposite of each other, that is, what is true in XOR becomes false in XNOR and vice versa. Now, we have studied all the 7 gates. Let us summarize these gates by a single table. We say that the type is basic, universal and exclusive. Let us understand them in form of input and output terminology. The AND gate has 2 or more input and 1 output. The OR gate has 2 or more input, 1 output. The NOT gate has only 1 input, 1 output. The NAND gate has 2 or more input, 1 output. The NOR gate has 2 or more input, 1 output. The XOR gate has only 2 inputs, 1 output. And the XNOR gate has only 2 inputs and 1 output. Now, let us move to the logic diagram and expression. Let us consider a very simple example of a logic circuit and its interpretation. Here in this circuit, we have considered that we are having 3 gates. One is NOT gate, second is AND gate, and third is OR gate, arranged in this fashion with 3 inputs X, Y, and Z and 1 output function F. Now, we say the output F is nothing but X directly going plus this AND output, where the output of this AND is nothing but Y bar and Z. So, here we have Y bar Z. So, the final output F is nothing but X plus Y bar Z. Now, since we are having 3 inputs, the total possible combinations can be 8, because 2 to the power 3 is 8. That means the total number of inputs what we can have for a given gate is nothing but it follows 2 to the power n, where n is the number of inputs. So, in this case, we have X, Y, Z. So, the possible values are 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1, 1. Now, when we solve this equation, we find that if X is 1 or Y bar Z is 1, then the output is 1. Then from the table, we find that 0, 0, 1 will yield 1, because 0, that means X is 0, but Y is 0 here, Y bar becomes 1. So, 1 dot 1 becomes 1. So, output is 1. And in these remaining values also, you can find that the output will be 1. Then for the input 3, for the input 2, and for the input 0, the output of this circuit will be 0. Now, we say that the Boolean equations, that is this, the truth table, that is this given table, and this logic diagram represents the same function. That means, if I say F equal to X plus Y bar Z, it is logically represented by this diagram. If I say I am given with a diagram, then the truth table is given by this form. If I say I am having this truth table, I can write this equation. So, it is nothing but a cyclic order where one suffice other. So, we now say truth tables are unique, but expressions and logic diagrams are not. This gives flexibility in implementing function. That means, this equation remains a constant, the truth table remains the same, but we can have different circuit representations for this given truth table, because we are available with different kind of components or different kind of integrated circuits comprising of gates. Now, let us move to Boolean algebra. We say that Boolean algebra is the fundamental of computers. That means the building of computer is based on Boolean algebra. Boolean algebra is nothing but certain mathematical functions applied over logic, where the logic are represented in form of gates. The gates are defined with form of equations, and equations are then defined in form of tables. Then all these representations are dependent on Boolean algebra. Now, basically in 1854, George Booley introduced a systematic approach to logic, and hence it is termed to as Boolean algebra. And in 1938, Claude Shannon introduced a two-valued Boolean algebra called as switching algebra, which is used in electrical circuits that are bistable circuit used to represent this algebra. So, we say that now Boolean algebra is basis of all the digital systems. Let us go in depth of Boolean algebra. Now, first we understand the principle of duality. Since we have understood that there are binary variables, there are binary constants, then we apply connectives, that is the logical connectives over these variables and these constants to yield the expression. Now, if we are given with an expression with variables and constants and operators, that is AND or NOT or so we say that in a given expression, if we keep variable as it is, but if we exchange dot by plus, that is AND by or by AND, that is plus by dot, and if we convert 0 to 1 and 1 to 0, then the yielded equation is nothing but the dual of the given equation. Formally, we say the dual of a statement S is obtained by interchanging dot, that is AND operator, AND plus, AND 0, AND 1. So, the dual of x dot 1 dot 0 plus x bar equal to 0 is x remains same. We convert this dot to plus, we convert this 1 to 0, we convert this dot to plus, we convert this 0 to 1, we keep the variable as it is, and we convert this plus to dot. Again, at the output, this 0 is converted to 1. So, from this particular equation, we have kept the variable x and x bar as it is, but we have converted dot to plus and plus to dot. So, we say that this equation is dual of this equation, or this equation is also dual of this equation. That means both the equations are interchangeable in duality. So, we say that dual of any theorem in a Boolean algebra is also a theorem. That means if I consider this statement to be a theorem, then the dual, that is this equation, is also a theorem. Now, let us have a concise look over Boolean algebra. There are fundamental laws in Boolean algebra. Let us understand them one by one. The first is x plus 0 is equal to x. That means if a variable x, which can hold two values 0 or 1, is odd with 0, then the output is x. That means we say 0 plus 0 is 0 and 1 plus 0 is 1. That means the value of x remains the same. Now, let us find its dual. So, x remains as it is, plus is converted to dot, 0 is converted to 1, x remains as it is. So, now we can say x dot 1 is equal to x. This theorem is called as identity element, because the value 0 or 1, that means if 0 is odd or 1 is ended, then the output is unchanged because it is equal to the input x. Let us move to the next theorem. We say if a variable x is odd with 1, then the output is 1. That means irrespective of the value of x, that is 0 or 1, the output will remain 1, because 0 plus 1 is 1. Again, 1 plus 1 is 1. Let us find its dual. We say that the dual is x plus is represented by dot, and 1 is replaced by 0, and 1 is replaced by 0. So, this becomes a AND law, and this is called as OR law. Let us move to the third theorem called as idempotence. In this theorem, we say if a variable is odd with itself, the output remains same, or if the variable is ended with itself, the output remains same. That means x dot x equal to x has a dual x plus x equal to x. That means in this case, if x equal to 0, then 0 plus 0 equal to 0, yes. If x equal to 0 here, then 0 dot 0 is 0 by AND law. Now let us move to the next law called as complement law. In this case, we say if variable is odd with its complement, it will yield 1, that is the identity element, or if the variable is ended with itself, it will yield a 0, again identity element. So in complement form, we say that if a variable is odd with its complement, the output is always 1. If a variable is ended with complement of itself, the output is always 0. Let us go for the next theorem called as involution. The involution theorem says that if a variable is complemented twice, then the output is the actual variable. That means if we place 2 bar over x, it will yield x. That means suppose we say the input is 0, first bar will make it 1, again the second bar will make it 0. So we say that the input and output are equal if we are having double bar over the equation. Now let us go for the next rule, which is called as commutative rule. Commutative rule says that the variable can be interchanged by their position, the circuit or the output will not be affected. That means we can say x plus y, that is x is odd with y, is equal to y odd with x. Its dual is also true, that x dot y is equal to y dot x. That means if x is ended with y, it is equal to y ended with x. The next rule is called as associative rule, where we can associate the variables by their group. For example, if I say x plus y plus z, because the operators are same, the bracketing can be changed. So here we can change the bracket, that is x plus bracket y plus z. That means first we can OR x and y, then the result can be OR with z, or we can OR y and z first and then we OR with x. The dual is also true, that is x dot y first bracketed then dot z is equal to x dot bracketed y dot z. That means we can AND first x and y and the result is then ended with z is equal to y and z ended and the result is then ended with x. This is the associative law. The next is distributive law. In distributive law, we can say that the variable can spread as of simple multiplication in arithmetic. That is, x multiplied by y plus z is written as xy plus xz. The dual is also true, that is x plus y dot z is equal to x plus y dot x plus z. It is distributive law. Let us go for the most important theorem of Boolean algebra, also called as De Morgan's theorem. The De Morgan's theorem says x plus y bar equal to x bar dot y bar. The dual says we have x dot y bar is equal to x bar plus y bar. Now in De Morgan's theorem, we have to note one thing, that x dot y bar is nothing but the equation of NAND gate, which is also nothing but equivalent to the individual input complemented and OR. The second law says that x plus y bar, it is nothing but the NOR gate, or in other words, it also says that it is nothing but inverted input AND gate. Let us talk of identity properties. We said that there are three fundamental identities: the NOT identity, the OR identity, and the AND identity. In NOT identity, we say if a variable is negated twice, the output is same variable. In OR identity, we say that if x plus 1 is there, it will give 1, x plus 0 will give equal to x. So 1 and 0 becomes identity of the OR gate. Again, if we take two variables a plus a, it is a, and a plus not of a, then it is equal to 1. The same thing goes with AND identities, where we say a AND 0 is equal to 0 and a dot 1, that is a AND 1 is a. The idempotent theorem says a dot a equal to a and a dot not of a is 0. So, here we say if a AND not of a is 1 and OR, then it changes to 0 when we find its dual in form of AND identity. Now, let us move to some useful theorems of Boolean algebra. The first theorem is minimization, where x dot y plus x bar dot y is equal to y. Here we can find that if we take y as common, then in bracket we have x plus x bar, which nullifies and we are remaining with y. Its dual is x dot x plus y, then ended with x bar plus y, it is also equal to y. The second law is called as absorption law, in which the variables are absorbed, that is x plus xy equal to x. Here we say if we take x as common, then in bracket we have 1 plus y, which is nothing but equal to 1. So, we say that x dot 1 is equal to x. The dual of this absorption law is x dot x plus y is equal to x. The next is called as simplification, where we can say that if x plus x bar y is there, then we can also write it as x plus y. Similarly, its dual is x dot x bar plus y is equal to x dot y. And the last is De Morgan's theorem, where again we define x plus y bar equal to x bar dot y bar, and the dual is x dot y bar equal to x bar plus y bar. In this lecture, we started with the definition of exclusive gates, in which we have defined two exclusive gates, one as XOR gate and second as XNOR gate, where one thing we have considered very important, that these two gates has only two inputs. Then we have studied the fundamental basis of computer science, that is Boolean algebra, founded by George Boole, followed by Claude Shannon. Then we have understood various theorems of Boolean algebra, and finally we have studied the De Morgan's theorem, which is nothing but the complementation of the NAND gate and NOR gate in form of inverted OR and inverted AND gates. Thank you.